Yeah, I just always, I've always just liked sort of pop music, really. I was just, you know, up until I was, you know, about 15 or 16, getting into bands and stuff, it was, you know, it was all pop radio, and I was like singing along to the radio and stuff, you know. I used to sing, you know, when I first started being in bands, I wanted to sing like Jeff Buckley or Thom Yorke, and I was, you know, trying to, doing loads of falsetto and stuff, and then got into soul a bit later on, and then R&B has just been a behemoth on the scene for the last 15 years or whatever, so. My mum's a singer. She's a session singer, and she sort of had a bit of a double life. She's doing her own stuff, which was like Celtic folk music, and she produced three of her own albums. And while I was growing up, and then you know, she was doing adverts and backing vocals on stuff, so I kind of had exposure to studios and gigs and those two different communities of musicians as well. I knew I didn't really want to make an acoustic record. That was just sort of an instinct, and I didn't really have the means to record it very well. And I think it's kind of easier to make electronic music sound fatter. When I started using more of those kind of sounds, there was kind of they're kind of occupying the same kind of territory as the acoustic guitar, or I was copying my parts. Then it became about trying to keep some acoustic guitar in there, and so I was having to fight for it on the other way around. So there's a couple of tracks in there. I'm
Yes.